Okay. You movie studios need to slow it down because there are too many trailers coming out. This is ridiculous. Hey, what's up, everyone, and welcome to another Gore's Trailer Reaction. And this one is for War for the Planet of the Apes, which is the third Planet of the Apes movie in the new rebooted series. I think it's like, what, the ninth Planet of the Apes film altogether? I think there's five original ones, and he had the remake, then he had the rebooted ones, and now this is the third of the rebooted ones. So I think nine. I could be wrong. Maybe eight? I can't remember. By the way, I am so excited for this because the last two were incredible movies. The Rise of the Planet of the Apes was great. Dawn of the Planet of the Apes was amazing. Really, really well done. And I can't wait to see this one. This one also has my boy Caesar, Andy Serkis, who should definitely get an Oscar nomination for one of these freaking movies because he's so good. And he does such a good job playing this character, this Caesar, of course. He needs to get nominated. He should have got nominated for Rise of the Planet of the Apes, in my opinion. He did such a really good job. And yeah, I'm excited. So let's just get right into it, even though I've been talking for over a minute. So here we go. Boom. I can't believe it. There's so many good trailers coming out. All right. Yeah. Okay. Hey, Maurice. The other one he had, like, oh, Woody Harrelson. That was Woody Harrelson, right? Oh shit.
All of human history,
he's the villain,
has led to this moment.
That's awesome.
The irony is we created you.
That's gonna be our Gary Oldman.
Nature has been punishing us ever since. This is our last stand. And if we lose, it will be a planet of apes.
Wow. Holy shit. That looks incredible. I think it's Matt. Is it Matt Reeves still doing it? That's his name, right? Matt Reeves? Holy shit. That looked really good. Oh, and you know what? I've been saying this for years. Ever since, well, actually, I guess ever since Dawn of the Planet of the Apes, which it's been years. It's been 2 years. But I have said the last film in this series should be called Planet of the Apes. If they're gonna finish it off strong and just say, hey, now it's Planet of the Apes. It's just straight up Planet of the Apes. And it looks like that's exactly what they're leading to. I mean, you've had Rise, then you've had Dawn, then you have War. I don't know what could come next. I feel like they're gonna try to do five movies. Okay, I don't know what could come next. I don't know. I don't know. I don't know. I really can't even think of what word they'd use for the next one. But screw the next one for now. Let's focus on this. That looked incredible. Cinematography-wise, special effects, holy shit. It looks so seamless now. I said that for Dawn of the Planet of the Apes, but this one looks even better. Like, hold on, when Caesar. It's really hard to make special effects look realistic during daylight. So a lot of times in Dawn of the Planet of the Apes, it was dark, it was in a forest. Even when it was daylight, it was darker. Here, like, this isn't completely bright and stuff, of course, but like, look at this, like, this shot right here, like, it's completely daylight. It looks fucking real. It looks so good. Holy hell, even the animations, of course, it's, you know, it's mocap, so you can't really screw that up if you have a damn good actor playing him. And of course, Andy Serkis is amazing. He looks so good. He looks so real. It makes me think back to Rise of the Planet of the Apes, where the special effects definitely look iffy, but the performances were so good, and even the animations and facial animations and stuff like that were so good that you kind of forgave some of the, you know, special effects. The budget also wasn't huge. It was like a $90 million budget. This is like, I think, the last one at least was $180 million budget. So they had a lot more money to work on these special effects. And I'm assuming the same thing for this, because the last one did so well. Hopefully this one does even better. And I am more excited now to see that Woody Harrelson's the villain. I heard he was in it, but I didn't know if he... Woody Harrelson always plays like the friendly, like, buddy. You know, he's always like the comedic, you know, like, hey guys, what's up? I'm Woody Harrelson. And here he's just like, I'm gonna fuck kill some apes. Like, okay. Alright, I'm in. I just saw Edge of 17, and that's exactly what he was as a character. Not I wanna kill some fucking apes, but he was like the friendly guy. I'm excited. I really am. This looks incredible. It looks so good. So I'm gonna give this trailer, you know what? I have nothing to complain about. Only thing I'm a little worried about is the main villain might have similar stuff to compared to the last main villain, Gary Oldman. And I was a little disappointed. If there was anything that was wrong with that last movie, I was disappointed with Gary Oldman's character, because he's an incredible actor, and his character was kind of one note. I don't like the apes. Why? Because my family died from the disease that was spreading around, the simian flu. That's why I hate them. So hopefully... he's not that one note. Obviously, he lost someone. He had a picture. So, I'm assuming so. Hopefully, it's not the same thing. But besides that, the trailer was incredible. I have to give the trailer a 10 out of 10. It did exactly what I wanted it to. It got me so hyped. So, War for the Planet of the Apes, official trailer. Amazing. Go check it out yourself. I'm super excited. So, anyway, there you go. Hope you enjoyed it. Thank you. Until next time, goodbye.